On the subject of identifying mind's nature and the importance of it, I have a story to share with you, a true story, which is about one of the amazing occurrences in the life of the great Indian master Nāgārjuna, who was a fully ordained monk. And of course, they would go out and beg for alms for the midday meal. And at one point, one woman approached him and offered Nāgārjuna a golden receptacle cup, which is studded with beautiful jewels, precious, authentic jewels, all around it to use for his begging bowl. Actually, in truth, monks are not supposed to receive or use these kinds of valuable objects, but because Nāgārjuna has no fixation or desire, he readily took it as though it was just something ordinary. And so he begged for alms that day using that receptacle. And there was one thief in the vicinity who saw this cup in his hand. And this thief thought, oh, this is really amazing. And he began to follow him, stalking him. And after Nāgārjuna had completed his lunch, then, omnisciently knowing what the thief was thinking, he actually gave the thief the cup. Now, the thief was incredibly shocked by this, as you can imagine. And he was so shocked that he couldn't contain himself, and so he had to ask the master, why would you give me such a precious thing? He just couldn't believe that this had happened. Why would you possibly give me this beautiful, valuable thing? You don't even know me. And Nāgārjuna replied to him, for me, this is not at all valuable in comparison with what is of much greater value that I possess and that I cherish more than anything. And the thief said, well, what could that be? What could you be cherishing more than something as valuable as this cup? And that was when Nāgārjuna told him about the preciousness of knowing one's own mind's nature. And he must have given him some pointing out instructions right on the spot. And so with that, the thief was very taken aback and thought that that was also amazing and believed him. And he asked Nāgārjuna, well, what should I do then with this information? Is there some way I can use this in terms of my life? And Nāgārjuna told him, well, you just go now, and whenever you have the urge to steal, apply what I've just told you. Watch to see the nature of the mind, the empty nature of the mind. Whenever you have the urge to steal, just do that. And so he said, okay, and he went off. And so for some 15 days, he did like this. Eventually he came back to the master, and he said, this was really something that caused difficulties to my vocation of stealing. Because every time I had the thought to steal and then I watched the empty nature of mind, I just forgot about stealing. I was unable to do it. And so this is what he had to report. And so Nāgārjuna said, well, then forget it. You shouldn't do this. You just go back to stealing. And he said, no. I can't go back to stealing because for the last 15 days, I've experienced the most blissful joy and happiness that was never even glimpsed by myself in this lifetime. It's been the most peaceful, happy time of my life. And so that was when he formally became a disciple of Nāgārjuna and in fact came to be one of the best disciples. He gave up all of his bad habits and turned his mind completely to understanding the meaning of Dharma. And so this is a true account from ancient times, but it does symbolize the point of what I'm trying to make to you, and I hope that it is helpful to you, and you can apply that to your own minds.